I'd like to take a moment and show you the process of creating an object diagram. You might also hear this process referred to as object decomposition. That is, we're taking something that's a big object, like an app, and we're breaking it down into its individual components. Now, there's no right or wrong way to do this. If 100 people create an object diagram for an app, there might be 100 completely different diagrams. Also, there are some informal and formal ways to create them. A formal way might be creating an object diagram using the Universal Modeling Language, or UML, and an example object diagram is given here on the left. Now, UML as a modeling language contains a bunch of standard symbols and icons that are helpful for laying out the components of a project. But for many, UML can be really bulky to work with. And I'd fall into that category. I'm more of a fan of an informal approach that takes some ideas from UML, but it doesn't get bogged down in the nitty-gritty details. And an example of a more informal object diagram is given here on the right. So for this example, I'm going to take an app that you'll see later called Alien Adventure. This is the main screen for the app, and I can interact with it by tapping on the screen. And we can see that this robot will animate across the screen, and there's an alien. There's actually multiple aliens. And the robot and the alien will have a discussion, and we'll go back and forth. And if the robot answers the alien's question correctly, then these little badges will appear in the lower left-hand corner of the screen. I'm going to stop right here. At this point, we've already seen enough of this app to actually start the object decomposition process. So I'm going to open a Google Drawing to build the diagram. But you could use a piece of paper, a napkin, a tool like Draw.io, which I have that opened up in this other tab here. This is a Draw.io diagram. Or really just any tool that gives you the ability to put your ideas into a diagram. Personally, I'm a big fan of napkins, and I can say from personal experience that a lot of great ideas I've diagrammed on napkins, and I'd lean to say that there's probably some other amazing apps out there that have been diagrammed on napkins, but that's a different story. The first thing we'll start with is the first big object, which is the app itself. Now, the app isn't an actual object in code, but that's okay. We're going to use it as our starting point. And if we think about what we saw when we were playing around with the app, we can start adding those objects to the diagram. So we know that there's a robot and that there were aliens. So I'm going to go ahead and make some rectangles to represent those. And we'll add labels for the robot object and the alien object. You'll notice that I'm using the singular form of alien and not aliens, even though there were multiple aliens in the app if we were to continue playing it. And this is a personal preference, and it's one of those aspects of UML that I'm blending with this informal approach. In UML, you typically refer to objects in their singular form. Also, if I was using a more formal process, I might use a certain type of symbol for an object, maybe a rectangle, and then a certain type of symbol for a struct, like a rounded rectangle. But again, because we're keeping it pretty informal, I'm just going to use rectangles for everything. Now, what else did we notice in the app? What else seemed to stand out in our mind as a self-contained entity? What else could be considered part of the application? Some of the things that I can think of are the background. We also had badges that appeared in the lower left-hand corner. And there was a dialog bubble at the top, and it consisted of multiple lines of text. This is a pretty good set of objects to start with. These were all things that we could clearly see with our eyes. But there could also be objects that are behind the scenes, things that we can't see, but still make up some part of the application itself. For example, what about the concept of a game world? Maybe the aliens, the robot, and everything within it could be thought as parts of a game world. So I'm going to go ahead and add a symbol for world to our object diagram. And adding world here is just another example of what I really want to stress to you. This process is not exact science. It's a very creative, abstract thinking type of process. No two people will probably create the same object diagram. Now, I'm going to go ahead and stop here. In just a moment, we're going to refine this diagram. We're going to think about how the objects are interconnected. And we're also going to look to see if any of the objects have similarities, because that's a big deal when designing apps. If some of the objects share traits and other similar functionality, then we can take advantage of that later when we start writing code.